Hello everyone, I've got Samrud Acharya with me, who's from the IS branch, and he has cracked Cohesity. So congratulations, Samrud.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So the package of Cohesity is 24.5 the CTC. It also has an internship starting from March onwards with 60K as the internship per month. So congratulations, Samrud. So tell me, this is one of the highest packages for this year.
Yeah.
So how did you, tell me first, what is the role that they are providing?
Yeah, so the role is site reliability engineer. So it's not like a normal developing field. Like, it comes as a interdisciplinary field between the both the developing as well as it includes operations as well.
All right. So Samrud, you tell me, so did you know about Cohesity when you heard about it? Because it's a company which not many people know about.
Yeah, I knew about Cohesity, but I didn't know about the job profile which for which they are hiring for.
Okay, okay.
So that I came to know only after, before the drive was announced.
Okay. So what were the rounds and...
Yeah, so there was altogether three rounds. The first was online assessment, which was followed by two rounds of technical interviews.
Okay.
So online assessment was for the period of 30 minutes, and it was it had 45 questions.
All right.
So it included the questions from aptitude as well as the technical.
Okay.
So coming to the aptitude part, it consists of questions from topics like time and work, time, speed, distance, as well as the logical topics like number series and coding, decoding. And coming to the technical part, the questions were from operating system, computer networks, and Unix. So the it included the Linux commands and all. So multiple choice questions were there. Mm-hmm. So it was altogether for 30 minutes.
Okay. So difficulty, how was it?
It was a bit difficult because the first thing was the lack of time. So 30 minutes, 45 questions, it was
too
bit
much.
Difficult.
Okay.
Yeah. But and even the options were a bit confusing. Uh-huh. All looked similar. Like, I remember some of the questions from technical round, in which they asked what is the command to list all the files in a directory. So the answer was ls hyphen lowercase I. So the options were in such a way that every option looks similar, at hyphen lowercase hyphen uppercase I. So all look similar. So because of that, the difficulty level was a bit high.
All right. And I think very few actually cleared.
Yeah.
Tell me one more thing, Samrud. What is the eligibility criteria in terms of percentage, you remember?
The eligibility criteria was 8 CGPA and above.
Okay.
And it was open for CS and IS brands.
Okay.
So, and no backlogs were allowed.
All right. So that itself would have filtered so many.
Yeah.
So how many cleared the first round?
So first round, only 6 people actually got shortlisted. And we were called for the first technical interviews.
Okay.
So yeah, majority of them were filtered over there.
All right. Can you tell a little bit more about the your technical round online? So they had what you said questions on.
Yeah, the questions were mainly asked from like the technical part included questions from networking and the Linux commands.
Okay.
We'll use the basic commands in Linux, whatever we normally use.
All right.
Those were included, and apart from that, yeah, computer networks and operating system related questions were asked.
All right. All right. And after that, you had your interview.
Yeah, so after that, I had my first technical interview.
Mm-hmm.
So he started off by asking my area of interest.
Mm.
So I told my I am interested in networking as well as cyber security.
Mm-hmm.
So then he asked me about the recent WhatsApp privacy policy update and what's my opinion on that.
Mm-hmm.
I told him regarding the policy update, whatever I know. And he asked me whether you'll stick on to WhatsApp itself or whether you will move on to any other alternative messaging apps.
Mm-hmm.
So then I told if the company like enforces the users to agree that, then I'll move on to some other alternative sources. Mm-hmm. But if they provide it as optional, then I'll stick on to WhatsApp itself.
Okay.
So then actually he asked me to share my screen and open the browser and enter my name followed by a word birthday.
Mm.
So search for my birthday, whether that is publicly available or not. So might be he asked that question because I spoke about the privacy update, right? So he just wanted to check whether how much privacy do I maintain.
Okay.
So might be because of that. But fortunately it didn't pop up. At least in the first page it wasn't displayed. So he was convinced about that. So later he asked me about how do we find open ports and the services that are running on a particular network. So I answered by saying we use a particular tool called nmap in Linux, in which we can get to know what are the open ports that are available as well as the services that are running on a particular network. Then he told what are the alternatives for nmap. Mm-hmm. So I told we can even use netcat. It's a tool in Linux, mm-hmm. Which does the same thing that of nmap. Mm-hmm. So after that he asked me how do we check whether the device in a network mm-hmm. is up and running. So I told we can use a command called ping, in which we can check whether the any particular devices in the network is up and running or not. Mm-hmm. So then he asked me, how can you do the same thing for if there is 100 devices connected to a network?
Mm-hmm.
I told we can write a program and store 100 IPs in a file, mm-hmm. and then fetch one each IPs at a time,
mm-hmm.
and then perform a ping command on that.
Okay.
So I answered in such a way.
All right.
So after that, he asked me about SSL certificates, then port forwarding,
uh-huh.
which are all the networking concepts.
Yeah.
After that, he asked me about the difference between HTTP and HTTPS.
Uh-huh.
So I answered the difference between them along with the example of Wireshark.
Uh-huh.
Wireshark is actually a network analyzer tool,
uh-huh.
which we use to find unencrypted messages that is passed in a network
mm-hmm.
in the form of plain text.
Mm-hmm.
But whereas in case of HTTPS, it will be encrypted so that we will not get to know the
mm-hmm.
whatever is sent over the network. So I explained with that example. So after that, he asked me to explain about the processes that
mm-hmm.
what are all the processes that we use in operating system.
Mm-hmm.
How do we how the process becomes a forward and a background process?
Mm-hmm.
Then how do we differentiate between the foreground and background process? So I explained him all about the process itself. Then at last he asked me about what is SSH,
hmm.
That is a particular command we hmm. use in this one Linux.
Mm-hmm.
So I explained him about that. So that was about the first technical interview. After that, I had a second technical interview. So it was a bit lengthy.
On the same day, did you have? Or
yeah,
okay.
I had both the interviews on the same day,
mm-hmm.
immediately after the first round.
Okay.
So there, actually, he started asking. He told me, suppose if you want to build a laptop,
mm.
so what configuration and hardware and software configuration do you use
mm.
to build a laptop and justify whatever you say.
Mm.
Like I started choosing a motherboard,
mm.
the configurations of the motherboard, that is LGA and PGA,
mm.
then the processor, then the hard disk, and then comes the graphic memory, whatever you use, and whether to choose HDD or SSD. So I told him regarding that.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, he asked me about again SSH. Why do you use and how do we connect between two different PCs
mm-hmm.
using SSH
mm-hmm.
and why it is used and whether I have used it or not.
Mm-hmm.
So then I told him like I have a VirtualBox which is installed in my laptop in which I run two different OSs. So I use that particular SSH to establish a connection between those two different operating systems. So that helped me a lot to explain whatever the concept of SSH is. So he was convinced about that. Then he asked me about the what is the cache memory, where it is fitted
mm-hmm.
in the CPU or whether it is fitted, and different types of cache memory.
Mm-hmm.
Then he gave me a scenario like he has a system and the cache memory is filled with some contents. So when the power goes off,
mm-hmm.
He just need to the contents of the cache memory need to be there itself.
Mm.
So what is the solution for that?
Mm.
So initially I didn't know the answer, but then he gave me a clue stating that he actually pressed upon the word if the power goes on, what can we do?
Mm-hmm.
So then I told him I got an idea of it. I told him that if the power goes off, we can provide a power backup.
Okay.
Like UPS or something, so that even if the power goes off, the system will be up and running.
Okay.
So the contents of the cache won't be erased.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, he asked me about difference between hard disk and SSD.
Uh-huh.
Why SSD is more faster than that of HDD.
Uh-huh.
I explained how the memory, the data stored in the memory in both SSD uh-huh. and HDD. And because of the memory, data stored in SSD in integrated chips, whereas in case of hard disk, a magnetic disk is used to store the data along with the ARM, which is used for reading and writing purpose. And that's the reason why SSD is more fast when compared to HDD. So then he again gave scenario-based questions. Like he asked me about the operating system processes. Like there is a system and there are many processes that are running. So the system runs out of memory.
Mm-hmm.
but the user still wants to run another process. Mm-hmm. So whether that process will be run or if it runs, then how does it run? So then I knew the concept of virtual memory. So then I told him the system uses a concept called virtual memory, mm-hmm. where it uses some memory from hard disk as a RAM, a temporary RAM. So then it runs that particular process in that memory. So that it doesn't affect the process that are already running. Mm-hmm. So I explained him regarding the virtual memory. So yeah, then he was convinced about that. And he has the difference between different generations of the processors, like mm-hmm. i5, i7 and i9. Mm-hmm. So I explained him regarding that.
So you knew all that?
Yeah, was interested in that. I used to watch the tech updates regularly. So it helped me a lot too.
Where do you watch all these tech updates?
Tech updates, I used to watch it in YouTube. Okay. Like search randomly and just all watch all those videos every day. So that helped me a lot. Uh-huh. Then again, regarding the virtual box, he asked whether you have used it or how the disk management, like the disk partition happens in terms of virtual box, he asked. Mm-hmm. So again, I had it in my laptop, I used it, so I knew about the disk partitions and all, so it was easy for me to answer that. Then he asked me whether I have used any cloud services or not. So I told him I have used AWS to run a virtual EC2 instance on the cloud. Mm-hmm. So then configure it. And also I did a course called Google IT Support. Mm-hmm. It's a specialization on Coursera. This is offered by Google. Mm-hmm. So there, for every theory concepts that they teach, we have labs on the cloud. Mm-hmm. Like it's running, the virtual machines will be running on the cloud, Google Cloud Compute Engine, which is their cloud service. There the virtual machines will be running. So we are supposed to connect to that virtual machines from our PC.
Okay.
So there we actually use the concept of SSH and all those things. So he asked me which SSH client do you use. Mm-hmm. So I told for Windows we actually use, there is a SSH client called PuTTY. Mm-hmm. So that particular SSH client we use for Windows. Whereas in case of Linux we use OpenSSH. So that's the client we use. So mm-hmm. Yeah, then he was okay with the answer. Mm-hmm. Then he told me if you have any questions regarding the company or job profile. So then I asked him regarding this particular job profile, which is completely new. Because
it's so different because you already had a product company role, which is really good.
Yeah, so there was not much of programming questions were asked. Uh-huh. Like it requires programming, but the whole job profile itself is not related to programming, completely related to programming. We have the operations task as well along with the development.
All right.
So I asked him about that job profile. I knew about it but wanted to know more about it. Then about the company, he explained about the company as well as their products and what they do at Cohesity. So what are their daily tasks and what is Cohesity known for. So everything he explained. So that was all about the interview process. Right.
So I'm so happy, at least, we have this year somebody, because last year nobody actually cleared this, so Samrit, what do you think was different in this interview compared to the other interviews that you have attended?
Yeah, as I said, this is not just limited to the development.
Uh-huh.
It involves development as well as the operations.
Okay.
So it is since it is for the position of site reliability engineer. So many of them will not be familiar with this kind of job profile. But I was familiar because as I said, I attended a course called Google IT Support.
Actually, I'm surprised that you actually attended a course because nobody will think of doing this.
Yeah.
What made you actually do that?
Because during the lockdown period, I thought of making or attending any of the courses.
Yeah.
But what had happened is in Coursera, this course was offered for free. So then that made me to look at all the contents and that made me interesting and I joined that course.
All right.
So it was a professional certificate and that specialization included 5 different courses. So that actually helped me a lot. And the instructors were actually site reliability engineers at Google.
Yes.
So before the beginning of that course, like during the introduction section, they explained what site reliability engineering is. So that actually helped me a lot for this internship, job profile.
Okay.
So I knew some little bit about SRE, but After that, he explained about more about that particular job. Okay. Profile.
So Samrit, any message, final message to the juniors in case they want to do well, or you know, because I think you have kept it very open. You know your everything very well. You are very, very well rounded. So that actually helped you to crack all these companies. So what would you say to them?
So the first tip is build your computer fundamentals really strong, because it may be the computer booting process, like when you switch on the laptop, what happens internally, you should know about that. That will be really helpful. Or it may, in terms of networking, you'll just type a particular domain in Google, suppose say www.google.com. What happens internally, if you are familiar with it, that is really helpful. And even in operating system, whenever you open the applications or different multiple applications, run multiple applications on your laptop, what happens internally and what operating system mechanism that is involved. If you know that, not only just from the interview perspective, but also from troubleshooting your own laptop problems, it helps in that way. So after that, whenever you are learning the network related things like Linux commands, just practice it on your own. Like you can just install a virtual box and try it all the commands and tools to establish a connection between two OS. In that way, if you learn, you know, because in the interview, they'll never ask a particular tool and why it is useful. They'll just ask scenario based questions. So in which you need to, you know, relate it to a particular tool. So if you know the how that particular tool and commands are used, you can easily relate it, and that becomes really helpful. So practical aspects is more important, or equally important as that of the theory. So that will be really helpful in it.
And maintaining your scores, because you had an 8 CGPA. What's your score?
Yeah, 8.1 CGPA. Eight. So since the cutoff was 8 CGPA.
That really matters. So thank you, Samrit, very much, and wish you all the best. And it's signing off from both of us till we meet again.